Resistance training breaks down muscle tissue, which causes more calories to be spent during the repair process, which is the next 24 to 48 hours. So work hard, then rest. All right, conditioning. This is what you look like doing conditioning. You're not working hard enough. Now, he's a stud. I mean, he's an animal. He can get away with it. And there are some people that are like, we put a heart monitor on them, and their heart rate's at 95%, and they still got a smile on their face, and they're loving it. Okay. So high-intensity interval training, which is you're either going to do a high-intensity interval training workout in the conditioning classes, or you're going to do a steady-state workout. A steady-state workout would be similar to what we did today. Who did the team training class? Nick, did you do team training class today?
Yeah.
What was your sets and or what was your work and rest?
45-15.
Okay, so that's like a conditioning day. That's a steady-state day. And the reason why I say conditioning or steady-state, because if you're going to work for 45 seconds, you're going to rest for 15 seconds. If you put a heart monitor on you, you're only going to drop by like maybe 5 beats if you're really in shape, right? And that's totally fine. There's going to be days where you're going to come in, and those days are going to be a high-intensity interval-based. You're going to have a heart rate monitor on. There's going to be your heart rate flashed up on the wall. And there's going to be days where you're going to come in, and it's going to be a 30-30, a 45-15, a 2 minutes on, 2 minutes off. That's totally fine, okay? Rather than talk about the conditioning, 45-15, 30-32, 2 minutes on, 2 minutes off, because that's really hard because it depends on how much rest you have versus how much work you have, I'm just going to talk about the HIIT training. Okay, so that's the heart rate-based training. And specifically, we're talking about something called afterburn. So afterburn is the elevated metabolic rate required to repair damage, repair muscle damage, replenish energy stores, and bring the body back to a baseline. Right? So this is kind of a fancy graph. Basically, everybody has experienced an oxygen debt or an oxygen deficit. So that, see where that green is? Where it says oxygen surplus epoch? And then right before that there's this blue area. Right? So basically, if you all got up right now and I said, okay guys, we're going to do jump squats. And we're going to do jump squats for 60 seconds. Everybody's going to be a little bit different. But anywhere between the first 5 to about 15 to 20 seconds, nobody's going to be breathing hard. And then after a certain point, we're going to start to have one person. Then we're going to start to, okay, and then everybody's going to be breathing hard. That's an oxygen debt. Okay, that first 5 to 20 seconds that you're not breathing hard, that's because your body's pulling oxygen out of all the blood that's already floating around. It's pulling oxygen out of your muscle tissues. Your body's already saturated with oxygen. You got to burn that oxygen off, and then that's what starts to make you huff and puff. And that's what we're looking for with the high-intensity interval training. It's basically just kind of hit that process. That's also what causes that afterburn, the elevated metabolic rate for 24 to 48 hours after the workout. So when you're doing a HIIT workout, heart rate monitor, okay, we're looking for red to green. It should be a sprint to walk. Now, what I want you guys to look for, I want you to look for, see there's a bunch of reds? Everybody see where there's a bunch of yellows or ambers, mm-hmm. And then there's a green. What we want is 85% to 70%. 85% to 70%. Okay? We don't necessarily want 90% to 78%. Okay? So I'd rather you get to 85%, because if you stop at 85%, your heart rate's going to go up a little bit. Right? So you might, so okay, cool, I got to 85%, you stop. And then 10 seconds later, you got 89%. Okay? So you'll get up there. I want you to go, wait, all the way through the green until you get to 70%, until you go again. Okay? 85% to 70%. Not 90% to 79%. Does anybody have any questions on that?
You may have to remind me.
What's that?
I said you may have to remind me.
Sure.
Well, what happens?
Like, most of the coaches are here, so.
What happens
if you can't get to?
Well, no. This is always a question that I have, because I can work in the red and I'm not
working that hard.
Like I can sustain it.
Yeah.
Like it's not. I'm not like dying or anything. And so, and I know I'm not sure if I've talked to you about it, but I've talked to Jamie about it and Chris about it. And I'm just, I don't know, when I'm at, you know, in the 80s, I'm just like, I can keep going. And
so there could be a couple things going on. Like your conditioning level could be up here versus your strength level might be a little bit off. You could have that going on. The app that we use uses a very standard 220 minus your age, right? And that's how it figures out your different zones, okay? That holds true for about 75% of the population. That doesn't hold true for 25%. So you might be higher, you might be lower.
Okay.
If you feel as though you're like, man, I'm at 92% and I could talk and I could rattle off my grocery list and everything like that, then have the coach go in and adjust.
Okay.
You're going to adjust your age down.
Sweet.
And so if you put in that you were born, if you put in that you were born in 1979,
perfect.
Then you're going to put in that you were born in 1989.
Even better.
Well, so it, what that does is that makes it so you have to work harder in order to get up higher.
I'm the opposite. I can never get
into the red.
Into the red. Ever. Right. Yeah. I'm like 85 max, and I did the whole dragon for an hour and a half and never got into the red.
So that's one of the reasons. What's that?
Same here.
So that's one of the reasons why I'm telling you guys 85%. Okay, because we do have some members that just they can't get in the red. So 85%. And then the other thing is that you would want to adjust your age up. So if you were born in 1979, you would say that you were born in 1969. But there's not much of a difference. 85%, 85% to 90%, I mean, you're talking about 5 beats. So it's not that big of a difference. The big thing with the high-intensity interval training is that you're going at a high intensity, and then you drop back down, and then high intensity, and then you drop back down.
Because I can get to the 83, 85, so I like that you say 85 to 70. Uh-huh. I can do that. It's classes where they're like, get in the red, and then stop. I can never stop.
Yeah, so 85.
What do you do for those that are like myself, where my, I have a reactive heart,
you just pop up really quick?
It pops up really quick.
You can drop your age down. Or no, you'd drop your age down. So if you were, again, if you're born in 1979, then you would put that you were born in 1989.
Okay.
You could try that.
Because I'm working pretty hard at 102%.
I mean, it also might just be one of those things where you respond very quickly. I mean, that's kind of what we want. We want your heart rate to, let's see if I, okay, if it's a HIIT workout, you are trying to get to above 85% as fast as possible. So let's say it takes you, you go from 70% to 85%, right? And let's say it takes you 30 seconds. Okay, and let's say it's a 20-minute workout. And let's say it takes you 30 seconds to get back down to 70%. So every minute you're working for 30 seconds. So that means that in that 20-minute workout, you're going to do 20 bouts. Does that make sense? All right, so let's say it takes me 30 seconds to get up, but it takes me 90 seconds to get back down. So I'm going to do less work than you. We're still working relatively the same in terms of intensity, right? But you're just, based on your system, you're able to get your heart rate up a little bit faster than I am. And that's okay. Your body will shut down before you hit that. Yeah.
That would not happen here.
So one of my jobs, I used to work with a military, and we would do a VO2 max test on them. And the people that I used to work with were able to push themselves so hard that we had to stand behind them. So they were on a treadmill with arms. And we had to stand behind them because they would work themselves so hard that they would either pass out or the treadmill would be going so fast that they would miss a step and they'd shoot off the back. 99.9% of people aren't going to do that. So you'll shut down before you get to a point where it's really dangerous. If you start to see stars, if you start to all of a sudden stop sweating, et cetera, et cetera, you'll...
Yeah.
No, you'll be all right.
Next class, when we're working on that, we need to start paying attention and like tracking it and talking to the coach if we're not getting to that zone that we want to be in.
Yeah.
Until
yeah.
We get it
do a class.
Yeah.
If you can get to 85%, you're okay. Don't change anything. You can't get to 85% and change something. If you're at 105% and you're like, oh my God, okay, then change something.
So rather than getting to the red and then stopping, you should get to 85?
Yeah, it'll carry you through to the red. I mean, it might carry you from 85% to 89%.
But if you feel like you're not working hard enough based on your colors, should you work harder? I'm afraid to feel like you're like, okay, I'm not doing anything.
Isn't this for the contest, though?
Well, that's generally speaking.
Oh, Jim.
Say that again, if you feel like you're not working hard enough.
Yeah, so you get up to 85% and you don't feel like you're super tired, or maybe really
that's
quickly
okay.
You feel like...
No, that means that you're ready. That means that you're ready to work.
Okay,
that's what you should feel like. You should be able to get to 85% and be like, "Oh man, okay, cool. I got to stop now."
Oh.
Not, you know, and you're staring at the clock. You know, it's better.
If you feel like you should go, you should.
That's what we want. Okay. You feel like you have a little bit more left in the tank. Not a lot, but a little bit more. Okay. Yeah. All right. Common mistakes. So I kind of hit on this already, high-intensity interval training versus resistance training. So at the end of a high-intensity interval training round, okay, at the end of like a 30-second, you know, rope slam, or when you get to that 85% or 88%, this is the posture that is common when we see that. Hands on knees, right? This is not the posture that we want to see you when doing resistance training. If you finish a set of step-ups and you're doing this, then you need to take a little more of a break before you start your next set of step-ups, okay? That's probably the biggest mistake, is that people won't push themselves hard enough in the resistance training. There was a girl, I wanted to shoot a video to illustrate this point, and so we had a high school girl that was in today, and she was doing step-ups. And she was doing step-ups with,
45.
What'd she start with though? 15s?
She had 20s.
Okay, so she started at 20s, and so I'm watching her, and I was like, nope, that's not gonna work. And so so I said, okay, grab 25s, she won 25s, I said, no, it's not gonna, 30s, you know, grab 40s. So she went from 20 pounds to 40 pounds. She went from 40 total pounds to 80 total pounds. She doubled her amount of weight that she lifted in one set. And unfortunately, she still wasn't breathing hard at the end because she's a conditioning freak and she's like 17 years old, so. But that just goes to show you are stronger than you think you are. You should finish that set. Remember, it's not necessarily a set of five, although for some of you doing a set of five, you're going to be breathing really hard. I breathe really hard after doing a set of five, okay? It's more in the 10 reps, the 12, the 15, the 25 reps, right? That's where you should put those weights down and you should be breathing hard. Not this kind of hard. If you're breathing like this, that means that you didn't rest long enough before you started that set. Generally speaking, the amount of rest that you should take between each set should be roughly 30 seconds to 2 minutes. It's a big range because we use reps anywhere from 5 reps to 25 reps. Okay? A good rule of thumb, 45 seconds, 60 seconds. That's a good rule of thumb. And if you find yourself not needing that rest, then that tells you that the set that you just did, you didn't work hard enough. Okay? On the flip side, if you're like, no, you know what? I did work hard enough. I was shaking, my muscles were burning, I was breathing really hard about 10 seconds after my workout, or after that set, but I still have another 50 seconds, do a plank, or do a quad stretch, or hang from the bar, do some stretches, do something that's going to help you bring your heart rate down. Biggest mistake, not doing what we tell you to do. Okay, so this goes back to the common mistakes, not hitting the 3 points of resistance training. Remember, burn, pump, strain. Burn, pump, strain. Gotta have those three things. Junk sets and reps. Junk sets and reps are basically, we don't really have, in our programming, there's not really a lot of junk sets and reps, but junk sets would be, let's say that you came in and today was 5 sets of 10 reps. And let's say for you, you only had to do 2 sets of 10 reps. That's all you needed. You got your pump, you strained, and you got your burn out of your 2 sets of 10 reps. Then the other 3 sets of 10 reps, those are junk. You don't need them. All you're doing is creating more damage that you have to repair. That's not going to help you lose weight or build more lean body mass because you already hit that on your 2 sets of 10. Okay? So that's a junk set. Don't think Remember, it's. Do you want to add something or do you want to subtract something? Let's go back. Review quick for everybody.
Mm-hmm. That's too far.
Keep going. No. It's generally addition of things that bring success, not the elimination. Okay? So if you're in here and you're like, all right, I got my two sets done, or I got my workout done, and man, that only took 35 minutes.
Whoa.
Did you pump? Did you strain? Did you get a burn on? If you did, you don't have to add anything else. Right? But if you did get those three things, ask the coach, hey, you know what? I don't really feel like I got a good burn in my biceps or whatever. The coach will give you something to do. If it's a 55-minute workout, go home. Some of the workouts, though, only take about 35 minutes to get done. And for me, I try and keep my workouts to about 30 minutes. So even those workouts that take some of you 50 minutes to do, I'm getting them done in 30 minutes.